Hello, good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Hey, how are you guys? How are you feeling today?
All time.
Always ready. Nice, nice. Ya casi viernes, ya casi viernes. Hung in there. All right. So good to have you here, guys. As always, it's a pleasure. Today we're going to be solving some situations about the homework. There was also a question about the midterm exam that I would like also to check with you, so that we don't have any problems at the time of completing, right, your homework and everything. So let's see. Just give me 1 second. I want to double check the date for the midterm. I'm not sure if it's going to be today, tomorrow. I'm kind of lost. So let me see. Here we go. Also today, yeah, today is the due date for the midterm. So we're going to check it. As well, we're going to take some time almost at the end of the class to check a couple of things related to the midterm, since as you know, it needs to be completed before midnight, right? Today before midnight. Okay then, so first things first, I'm going to take attendance so that we start with the class. So let's see, I'm going to call your names and pretty much you just say present. So here we go. So we start with Ana Beatriz Campos de Guzmán.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Beatriz, nice. We continue with Blanca Elizabeth Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Blanquita, nice. Then we go with Carlos Antonio Escobar Hernandez.
Present.
Thank you very much, Charlie. Good. Then we continue with Carlos Javier Crespin. Carlos Javier Crespin, not here yet. So then we continue with Christian Ernesto Lazo. Christian, not here. So we continue then with Denise Grisel-Brizuela. Denise Grisel, not connected yet. So we continue with Mr. Ember Giovanni Polio.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you, Ember, very good. Then we continue with Francisca Elizabeth Martinez Gámez. Elizabeth, not here, not yet, okay? So then we continue with...
Teacher, I mentioned me.
Yes, just some minutes ago. So, Denise Grisel Brizuela.
Yes.
Nice. So you're here. So, nice. So there you go. Thank you, Grisel. So we continue with Jose Eduardo Guzmán. Jose Eduardo, not here, okay. So we continue then with Juan Carlos Rivas Jovel. Juan Carlos Rivas, not here, okay. So then we continue with Karen Vanessa Moratalla. Karen Vanessa, not here. So we continue with Luis Alfonso Martinez.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you very much, Luis. Welcome. Then we continue with Maria Elena Guadalupe Peñate. Maria Elena, one, Maria Elena, two, not here. So we continue with Nelson Gabarrete Merino. Nelson Gabarrete Merino, not here yet, okay? So we continue with Omar Francisco Hernandez.
Present.
All right, thank you very much, Omar. Very good. We continue with Oscar Arnulfo Villatoro.
Present.
Thank you, Oscar. Very good. And last but not least, Jenny Suleyma Santos. Jenny, not here yet. Okay, so not here yet. All righty then. So let's get started. Okay, so first, let's have a little activity before we actually start with the general review. Today, we're going to have a general review on all the topics that are included in the test, the different things that are going to be considered for the evaluation. So we're going to go over them and we will check a little bit also about the test so that we can, as I said at the beginning, do a good job, right, in the evaluation. Alrighty, so here we go then. Now, the first thing we're going to do, as I was telling you before this little review we're going to have, we are just going to, let me share my screen, and let's see how much you remember about a couple of rules about these tense. Many people say the simple present is not that simple, right? And it's actually not. There are a lot of rules that we have in the simple present that we sometimes forget, and that's understandable because they are a lot, right? So I'm going to share here my screen and we're going to have a little review by using Kahoot to play something related to the simple present tense. So let's see, this is the pin number we're going to use. And remember to connect, you just need to go to www.kahoot.it, right? So there you go. Let's see. All righty. So I'll wait for you to connect. There we have Carlos. Very good. Ember, nice. Blanquita, very good. I'm waiting for the rest. Oscar Villatoro, Grisel Valdez, nice. Omar, very good. And are we missing? We're still missing a couple of people. There we have Luis, excellent. Beatriz, nice. Someone else. We're still missing, let's see, Elizabeth. Yeah. And Christian, I guess. All right.
Teacher, in my case, no he llegado a la casa.
Oh, you're not home yet? Oh, no, so don't worry. Okay, don't worry, Ellie. So thank you very much for letting me know. So maybe you can just listen to the game then, and then once you arrive home, then you, you join us, right? But nice. Okay then, so let's start with the game, game/review. And if you haven't been able to connect yet, don't worry, right? You still can connect while we are playing. You still can enter the ping number and you can connect, so no problem. So here we go. Let's start then. So Simple present. Let's see how much you remember about the uses of the simple present. So here we go. Number one, Usain Bolt. What do you think? Faster than anyone in the world. What do you think is the correct answer? Don't let me down. Pilas, pilas, let's see. And time. Let's see. Oh my God, my heart is aching. Jesus Christ. Menos mal que ya cené, si no ahorita cayera aquí desmayado. So, Usain Bolt. If I don't want to use Usain Bolt, right? The name Usain Bolt, that's the name of the runner. If I don't want to use his name, what is a pronoun that I can use to replace it? Uh-huh.
He.
He, exactly. So I should use he, right? And then if you remember, with the simple present tense, and this is one of the rules that we forget most of the time, we need to add an S or ES to the verb if we are using as a subject any he, she, or it, right? The third person singular. So in this case, it would be runs. Usain Bolt runs faster than anyone in the world. There you go. So don't forget the rule. Here we go. Carlos Escobar, first place with 0 points. So let's see that. No, just kidding. Let's continue. Number two. All right. So it says he to work every day. He to work every day. Let's see, let's see. Don't let me down on this one. Ay, ay, ay. There were still some people who actually selected walk. So this is what we just mentioned. If I have a he, a she, or an it, then I need to add the S right to the verb. So I would say he walks to work every day, right? He walks to work every day. If I use walk, right? No, no way, Jose, I cannot do this because I'm using the third person singular. So, all right, let's see positions. Ember, first place. Grisel, Carlos, Oscar, and Blanquita. Let's see, next one. Number three, they dinner together every night. They dinner together every night. What would it be? Five, four, three, two, one. Just one person. Oh my God. So what happened? Let's see. Teacher, ¿y aquí por qué no era it? Pues se acaba de decir que lleva la S, el verbo, hombre. ¿Por qué no? ¿Por qué no era?
Because it's day.
It's day, bingo. The rule about the S, the third person singular, only applies for he, she, and it. In other words, that means that if I have he, she, we, he, she, it. If I have this, any of these pronouns, then that means that my verb is going to add an S or ES, right? Depending on the verb. Some verbs, they take the S, some others take ES, right? We are going to check some of those verbs that actually take the ES. Now, what happens with the rest of the pronouns? If I'm not using he, she, it, then I have, that means I, you, we, and they. So if I have these pronouns, that means that my verb doesn't change, right? So the verb stays in the base form. Like in this case, they eat, right? No changes in the verb, they eat. Y teacher, pero si tengo José, right? En vez de un pronombre de estos, me parece José, Johnny, Margarita, whatever. So if that's the case, then I substitute or I relate this to any of the pronouns. Si tengo Johnny, for example, then that means that is a he, right? And I use the same rule of the third person singular. All right. Any questions so far? No questions? All right. So we continue then. So let's see. Just let me erase this. All right, I start. So here we go. Positions, Grisel going to the first place. Very good. Second, Ember. Third, Carlos. Fourth, Oscar. And Blanquita. Here we go with the next one. He, snowboarding every winter. He, snowboarding every winter. Let's see. Excellent. There you go. You see, he goes snowboarding every winter. Good. So I cannot use just go here because I have he. Now, if you notice, I didn't just add the S. So I didn't say goes. I say goes, right? When am I going to use the ES in some verbs? If the verb ends in, when we have O, we have double S, CH, SH, or X, I forgot the dash here. In these cases, then I'm going to change what I add, and this is going to be ES. Like in the case here, we have go, this changes to goes. I have, for example, kiss, then this changes to kisses, right? Imagínense, le agrego solo la S a kiss, me desinflo, kiss. Kisses. She kisses me, right? Really sweet. Just an example. So, etc., etc. Here we have also watch, watch. So, watch, watches, watches. Then we have la famosa combinación wash and watch. Washes, right? Washes. Be careful with this. Some people tell me, teacher, I'm washing TV. I'm washing TV. Lo va a arruinar. Se le echa agua y jabón al tele. So it's going to get broken. So you don't wash TV. You watch, watch TV, watch. So we have watch, wash, watches, washes, right? And we have the last one, any verb that ends in X, like for example, fixes, right? Fixes. So there you go. Nice. So all this, whenever we have verbs that end in these endings, right? In these letters or combination of letters. So there you go. Nice. ¿Lo puedo borrar? Yes. Can I? Okay. Let's see. So let's continue. I guess this one went better. Grisel, on fire. Ember, Carlos, Oscar, and Carlos Lopez. Very good. Here we go. Next one. The baby, vegetables. The baby, vegetables. Mm. Excellent. There you go. So the baby hates vegetables. What is the pronoun that I can use instead of the baby in this case? What's he. The pronoun? Huh?
He.
It could be a he or a she, right? In the picture, we had a girl, so it would be a she. But in theory, if we just read the sentence, then it would be either or, right? He or she. So very good. Then we have next one. All right, so we have Grisel, Ember, Oscar going up, Carlos Escobar, and Carlos Lopez. The Carloses. Let's see. Number six. They very excited. They very excited. All right, there you go. So they are very excited. So it cannot be is. Is is for singular. And we have plural here. They are very excited. Excellent. Let's see. Same positions. Grisel still on fire. Number seven. The cat. The dishes on the weekends. Que galan fuera. Let's see. The cat, the dishes on the weekends. We just checked it. Very good. So remember this verb wash ends in sh, right? So we cannot say washes, 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 es. Excellent. Washing, ing, no, right. So, es. Same positions, Grisel still on fire. Number eight, sometimes Miley Cyrus and Ariana Grande together. Together. Ay, 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 what happened here? So here we have this name, right? Ariana Grande. So we say, so it's a she. But we also have Miley Cyrus, right? Miley Cyrus and Ariana Grande. So what can I say? What pronoun can I use then if it's two people?
They
exactly. So they sing together, right? No S in this one. So let's see. All right, so we have Grisel still on fire, Ember, Oscar, Carlos Escobar, and Luis coming back to the action. Luis, very good. Here we go. Next one. The scientist sometimes experiments. The scientist sometimes experiments. Nice. The scientist sometimes does experiments. The scientist. It can be a he or a she. In this case, in the picture, we had a he, right? So he sometimes does experiments. cannot say do, right? Because that would be for different pronouns. Dos, no, right? So that's a number in Spanish. So we need es, does, right? No dos, there you go. Next one. All right, Grisel still on fire. Carlos Escobar going to the second place. Oscar, Emperor, and Luis. The last one, last question. She a pet cat. She a pet cat. She a pet cat. Nice. She has a pet cat. Have and has, they are like the very, they are like somehow an exception. Why? Because have is the only irregular verb in Spanish. And I say that it's irregular because we don't say haves, for example, haves, So what do I do if I want to use the form of the third person singular for have? Then it is going to change to has. It's almost like if it's a complete new word, right? So it's have and has. It's like if they are different. So the rule of the S or ES doesn't apply on has, right? So it's pretty much something different. Right. So let's see, final scores. Final scores. So we have third place. Let's see, Oscar, very good. Second place, Carlos Escobar. And the first place, the queen of the person, Grisel Valdez, very good. Special mentions to Victor and Luis, respectively, fourth and fifth place. Very good. All right, so there you go. So you see, this is the simple present, right? So I know whenever we're speaking, for example, we forget the yes, we forget the yes. We don't think that much. And these rules of the simple present, we need to have them, or we need to keep them always in mind. So don't forget it, right? Don't forget these important rules. Okay. All righty then. So let's see, before we move on to this review that I have for you today, I have another thing for you. So I want to have this little, let's say, listening practice also, but I didn't want to have like the regular listening practice that we can have maybe some other time. So I decided to share with you something that I like and something that actually could help you. Do you know Jimmy Kimmel? Are you familiar with this TV host? No. All right. So he has a show, which is the Jimmy Kimmel, Jimmy Kimmel Live or the Jimmy Kimmel Show. And in this show, he pretty much speaks about a lot of stuff, right? They have sketches, they have different sections there in the show. And one of my favorite sections in the show is the pedestrian question. Do you know what a pedestrian is? Does somebody know? Pedestrian, what's that? Any ideas on what a pedestrian is? Or no ideas? A pedestrian is a person who walks on the street, right? A random person that is walking on the street. In Spanish, we would say un peatón, right? That's the meaning of a pedestrian. So this name of the section is the pedestrian question. Here they ask random questions to people And today's question, it says, couple, siblings, or strangers. You know what a couple is, right? You know couples?
No, teacher.
No? Couple is your significant other, right? The person that you live with, or the person that you love, that's your couple, right? Su pareja. Y antes, los profesores decían working couples, pero no, vea, couple es pareja, pero es algo romántico, no es que voy a ser pareja ahí con cualquiera en la clase, vea. Hey, let's work in couples. Careful, vea. So no, that's a pair, right? Let's work in pairs, so it's different, right? So, couple is a romantic thing. What are siblings? What's the meaning of siblings?
Hermanos,
hermanas. Aha, exactly. Brother and sister, right? If I have, for example, two brothers and one sister, I cannot say I have three brothers because I have one sister. And I cannot say I have three sisters because I have two brothers. So I say I have three siblings, right? The word siblings involves brother and sister, right? Hermanos, el término incluye hermano y hermana, right? So those are siblings. And strangers, someone that you don't know, right? People that don't know among each other, right? So those are strangers. Extraños, right? Desconocidos. Now, we're going to watch the interview. They're going to have here, and they're going to ask people. And I'm going to pause the video, and you're going to tell me what you think these people are, if they are couples, siblings, or just strangers. So let's give it a try. Here we go. Listen.
If you don't know, is on Hollywood Boulevard, which is home to some of the greatest people watching. A lot of the people outside need to be watched at all times, so we watch them. We went out on the street and we asked pairs of people walking by, are you a couple, siblings, or strangers? So the way this works is we'll see two people, introduce themselves, and based on this very superficial first impression, we'll try to guess how or if they are related to one another. You understand? Okay, good. Let's play.
Hey, what's your name?
Lindy.
Alyssa. Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
All right.
Oh, my God. All right. So there you go. So here's the question. What do you think? Are they a couple, siblings, or strangers? What do you think?
Siblings.
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 Siblings. They look alike. Siblings. Yes.
Teacher, but I understand you say simple, hermano y hermana. In this case, is two women.
Yes, in this case,
they are sisters.
Just, yeah, they are just using the question as it is. Están lanzando la pregunta en general. So that's why they are not being specific in telling them, are you sisters, right? They just use siblings, right?
Pero, yeah. Le voy a preguntar en español. Es que lo que yo no comprendí, cuando usted dijo sibling, era hermano y hermana, pero
yes,
un conjunto donde están hombres y mujeres, o yes, solo mujeres y solo hombres.
No, sí he entendido bien. In this case, yes, Elizabeth. So, el término aplica para los dos, o sea, perdón, para el hermano y hermana, right? Uh-huh. Para eso utilizaríamos, ellos son siblings, por ejemplo. Uh-huh. Acá ellos solo están haciendo la pregunta en general, o sea, como la harían a cualquiera, ya sean si son hermano, hermana, dos hermanos, dos hermanas, solo están haciendo la pregunta que base, ¿no? Que ya tienen ellos ahí. Aunque lo que tal vez sería más apropiado acá es decirles, sisters, are your sisters? Uh-huh. Yeah, so it could be.
Nice. Thank you, teacher.
Nice, anytime. So let's see. So you said that they are actually related, that they could be sisters. So let's see.
Or strangers.
All right. Are Lindy and Alyssa a couple of siblings or strangers?
Siblings.
Siblings is the answer from the majority of the audience. Let's see.
Oh, we're a couple. Yeah, a couple.
Oh, my God.
Right. Which is the answer we're looking for.
You see, it could happen.
Teacher, lo supe porque no se parecen.
Well, there you go. So they are a couple, right? So not siblings. De hecho, sí. Yo sí creía que se parecían, pero...
No, yo no, no se parecen.
Really? Okay, my eyes deceive me.
Pero tampoco parecen capo.
Okay, good point. Let's see the next one.
So a wave of horniness suddenly went through the audience. Next up.
Hey, what's your name?
My name's Jake.
Kelly. Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
What about... these people here, couple siblings couple. Or strangers? Couple
siblings.
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 Couple. I had 50-50 siblings and couple. Let's see. Let's find out.
Are Jake and Kelly couple, siblings, strangers? Well, the audience is very split here, and we don't have any measuring devices, so well, let's find out what they say.
We are strangers.
Strangers.
They didn't know each other.
If she was his girlfriend, there's no way she'd let him wear that shirt. Who's next?
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
How's it going?
What's your name?
Avery.
Kim.
Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
All right, what about this one?
Couple.
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 No siblings?
No.
Okay. See? They don't look alike. Okay, but some people say siblings. Couple. Let's see. Let's find out.
Are they a couple, siblings, or couple? Audience says a couple? A few strange, mostly couple. Let's see.
Strangers.
Oh my God, they got us
again. They didn't seem so sure about that, though, did they? Next up.
He's close.
Gerarda.
Justin. Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
Well, I don't know what to think. What do you say?
Couple? Stranger.
Strangers.
Strangers?
Stranger. Yeah.
Strangers? Many people say strangers.
Siblings.
Siblings. Siblings. Maybe. Yeah, they look suspiciously close, right? So you say couple.
It's a couple, teacher.
It's a couple. Let's
for the
see.
For the shirt.
Very good observation, Iggy Azalea. We'll see.
Your
we'll
face. See.
Let's find out.
Most everyone says couple, and let's see, are they a couple siblings or strangers?
Strangers.
Oh, nice.
That could have gone either way. Yeah, the
the
X-factor was the Iggy Azalea shirt.
Well, you got it.
Our next pedestrian pair is?
Hi, what's your name?
Bailey.
Connor.
Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
What about this one?
Stranger.
Strangers?
Siblings.
Siblings. For me, siblings.
They look similar. They have similar features, right? Maybe siblings. Let's see. Let's find out.
Siblings or strangers?
Oh, everybody seems very resolute about this one. The verdict is?
Siblings.
Oh, my. There you go. Siblings.
By the way. You know, is it just me or do they seem disappointed? All right, next.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
Brandon.
Victoria.
Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
What do you think they are? Couple. They look like they are holding hands.
A couple, pero se parecen.
ya le va metiendo. All right, so.
Teacher. Y en la vida real, ¿usted no ha visto unos esposos que se parecen o que tal vez el esposo, la esposa se parece al hermano del esposo?
No, eso sí no lo he visto. Lo segundo no. Lo primero sí.
Yo sí.
They look alike. The wife and the husband, yeah. That I have seen. But the brother-in-law or the sister-in-law, no, not really. But yeah, it happens, I guess. All right. So let's see. But let's see about these people. Let's see if they are actually related or not.
I'm hearing couple and siblings. I'm not hearing strangers. How do we think Brandon and Victoria are related? How?
Couple.
There you go. No,
they're a couple. Sounds like they might not be a couple for long, but they're a couple.
Okay.
We have two more.
Hi, what's your name?
Lexi.
Todd.
Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
They look weird. What do you think?
Couple.
Siblings.
Yes. Siblings. Couple, siblings.
Couple.
Couple.
Siblings.
Strangers. Siblings. Let's see.
Couple. And Todd, the loudest portion of the audience is saying strangers. Let's find out.
Strangers.
Maybe.
Do you think there could be more? Nice.
Maybe.
I need a green card.
I can help with that.
They're making love behind the Wetzel's pretzels as we speak. And we have one more.
Hi, what's your name?
Shane. Keaton.
Are you guys a couple, siblings, or strangers?
What do you think?
Strangers.
Siblings?
Siblings.
Siblings. All right, no couple. Siblings or strangers? All right, let's see. Let's find out.
Are Shane and Kingston couples, siblings, or strangers? It'd be weird if they were strangers. Isn't it? Well, let's find out.
Siblings.
Do you want to give your brother a kiss?
Get that kid a cootie shot. I am Jimmy Kimmel. If you like that, subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all our latest videos before they die and go to YouTube heaven.
There you go. Okay, so this is just something different, something that you might try, or this is something that I like, right? This is just my personal selection or my personal opinion, in which we can have fun. We can actually pay attention to something that can help us to improve our listening and even our speaking, because we can use this type of practices or this type of material to learn vocabulary, to understand a little bit about the pronunciation and intonation, right? When native people speak, right? Etc. This is really nice material because it's real English. This is what I call real English. He's not thinking maybe they are not going to understand. He's assuming that you will actually understand what he's saying. This is comedy. Comedy is a nice way, like a nice tool to learn English. If you don't like, for example, this type of shows, look for something you like. You can look for something related to business, something related to engineering, something related to cooking, video games, comics, whatever, right? Whatever actually calls your attention, look for it in English. You're going to find a lot of things on YouTube. So take advantage of that, in which you can activate the subtitles in English so that you can read what they are saying. You can activate subtitles in Spanish if it's the first time you are listening to it, as you prefer. But look for this type of material, which is going to help you, as I said, because it's real English, right? It is what it is. It is what you're going to see, and it's what you're going to find if you speak with a person who is from the United States or from England. So just something for you to keep in mind. All righty. So let's see. Wait. All righty. So let's talk a little bit about, before we continue, the homework assignments and the problems that you were having with these, with these exercises. I found out, for example, let's see. If you remember the other day, we were having this problem with, I guess it was homework number 6, right? With homework number 6. En la tarea número 6, teníamos por ahí un problema, creo que era la número 5, la que no nos daba ni con una cosa ni con la otra. Y por ahí ahora me hacían la observación. Algunos ya intentaron avanzar con el examen, con el midterm, y ahí se repite, como que lo hicieron a propósito, se repiten algunos de los ejercicios de la misma tarea 6. Entonces se nos dio el mismo problema, ¿no? So, la cosa es, let me see. Not this one. Wait, here it is. Este es. Ok, si revisan la tarea, bueno, la tarea 8, a propósito, el problema es, no incluyan los pronombres, ¿verdad? Si ya tiene el you, no me le vuelvo a poner you are not allowed, right? Ni lo escribamos la oración completa. Solo tenemos que poner lo que falta en el espacio en blanco. Eso es todo, right? Por ejemplo, la número 1 dice you to cheat on an exam. Solo me falta la expresión not allowed más el verb to be. O sea que en este caso, you are not allowed to cheat on an exam. And just like that, right? Y ahí no le va a dar problema, ahí sí le va a pasar la pregunta. Con la número 6, veamos. Here it is. Esta sí se la voy a compartir. Bueno, con la número 6, teníamos el problema con todas estas. Y el problema es casi que lo mismo. Acá dice, find the mistake and correct it. La mayoría, incluyéndome, porque yo también lo hice así, estábamos escribiendo toda la oración. O sea, la volvíamos a escribir ya de la manera correcta, ¿no? Eliminando el error que identificábamos. Pero el ejercicio lo que pide es que solo escribamos el error. O sea, que solo pongamos la palabra que está mal.
Ya la tengo buena yo, teacher.
Ay, excelente, me llega. So, esa era la situación con este ejercicio. No es que, ahora bien, en algunas hay más de un error. Eso no lo hice yo, que conste, me lavo las manos. Pero hay más de un error, entonces, de hecho, tenemos que ponerla así como está, ¿no? Y solo a corregir a veces el error del verb to be. Por ejemplo, there are a store in the city. Entonces aquí solo tengo que poner is, porque solo voy a cambiar el are, right? Entonces solo le pongo is. There is one offices in San Miguel. Aquí cambio la palabra offices por office. There is one office. There is three distribution centers. Are three distribution centers. And there is a news office. New. There are not a person.
Teacher, uh-huh. I'm sorry.
Tell me.
The number three. Uh-huh. Yo la tengo como usted dijo, pero me sale mala.
La number three, ¿a dónde?
The number three. There. there are three
distributions. Escribí la A mayúscula.
Ajá. Incluso con la minúscula me la tomó como buena ahorita. Son, no sé qué será el error, Luis.
Distribution center.
No me la escriba toda, Luis. Solo
only,
R.
Only R.
Ajá. Just R. Así como la está viendo aquí en pantalla, la número 3. Y no vamos a escribir toda la oración. Y es lo que decíamos, ese era el error que estábamos
teacher.
Pero en las otras hemos escrito toda la oración, teacher.
No hay día, Dan. Eso creo que, bueno, eso es lo que a mí me había confundido. Y por eso yo estaba escribiendo toda la oración. Porque en algunas sí las he aceptado y en otras no. So,
wow.
Ahí es donde yo me quedo. ¿Qué onda? Pero si seguimos la lógica de la indicación, solo nos pide el error, ¿verdad? Por eso dije yo, no le voy a poner solo el error, solo la palabra que estaba mal, y a ver si lo toma. Y ahí sí me lo tomó. Así como
entonces sería solo, solo R.
Ajá, lo deja solo R y se la tendría que tomar. Bueno.
Con la A mayúscula lo agarras.
Ah, well, there you go. Pueden intentar con la A mayúscula, con la minúscula. Bueno, ahorita me lo acaba de agarrar con la minúscula. So, pretty much, let's see. Le estoy compartiendo una pantalla. ¿Están viendo mi pantalla ahorita? ¿Sí?
Yes.
Yes, yes, right. Okay, nice, nice. There you go. Yes. All right. Perfect. Entonces, les hago esta aclaración para este ejercicio porque, then again, en el midterm, en el examen, y en la parte 3, se repiten algunas de estas oraciones y la indicación es la misma. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que van a hacer? Solo pongan la palabra que ustedes...
Solo el error.
El error. Ajá, nada más. Solo eso. No pongan toda la oración.
Ok.
Y,
sorry, teacher. Sorry, ajá. Teacher.
Yes,
en el 1, 2 y 3, usted solo ha puesto el error. Sí, yo las he puesto completas, pero me las toma buenas.
Yes, eso es lo que estábamos diciendo, Luis. Creo que en estos ejercicios, cuando los diseñan, ponen diferentes opciones que se aceptan como correctas. El error acá ha sido que...
Les pusieron... Olvidaron ponerle completas.
Ajá, exacto. Después. Olvidaron poner que también en las demás... debería de ser tomada correcta la respuesta completa. Entonces, esa discrepancia es la que nos hizo dudar, ¿verdad? Que si o solo poníamos todo completo o en unos solo el error o cómo era la cosa. Pero, si se quieren ir a lo seguro, solo pongan el error, ¿verdad? Para no estar adivinando cuál es la que sí acepta la completa y cuál es la que no. De un solo se puede ir a escribir solo el error. Right. So there you go. In the part of the test that I was telling you is this one here. Ya se lo voy a enseñar. Here, in the midterm. Por cierto, recuerden que este midterm lo tienen que subir hoy antes de las 12, right? So pretty much you need to do it. If you haven't done it so far, do it after the class, please. No se le vaya a pasar ahí la hora, right? Y acá, bueno, pretty much la primera parte is multiple choice. You just need to select the option that you think is the correct one, depending on the sentence. That's part one. In part two, let's see. In part two, there you need to, well, it says the use of imperatives, right? To give instructions or to make invitations. So you need to, again, just select the option you think is the correct one, just multiple choice. And then you have in the part number three, what I was telling you. En esta parte es donde yo les digo, se repite. Uy, a la respuesta, Dios santo, wait. Wait. All right. So let me just delete this.
Hey, le había dejado
Ah, caray.
No, teacher.
Hey, no, hombre, ya me subí. All right, so let me see. Uy, no pude quitar la 4. Lo voy a enseñar.
Solo bueno, el que fue listo, creo que le tomó captura a la pantalla.
Obvio, espero que no sea el caso. All right, so acá es lo que les decía. Se repite el mismo, la misma indicación, ¿no? Find the mistake and correct it. So, y en esta parte solo pongan el error, no, para que no vayan a estar intentando que sea completo, no es completo, porque yo creo que en esta, de hecho, ninguna agarra completa. No se vayan a asustar si lo ponen todo, y aunque ustedes sepan que está gramaticalmente bueno, se los niegue, porque han dejado que agarren la respuesta correcta, solo tomando la palabra que es el error.
Solo con error.
Ajá, ya corregido, ¿no? Solo una palabra van a poner. And that's it.
Okay.
Nice. That's for part 3. And let me see. Then we just have part 4. In part 4, pretty much. There you go. So it's, again, a completing, right? Read the following sentences and complete them using the proper form of not allowed. Pay attention to the pronouns. So, aquí, lo mismo. Solo van a poner la expresión. No me van a poner toda la oración, sino solo lo que falta en el espacio en blanco. Okay? Nada más. So, that's it, right? Y eso sería. Any questions, doubts? I don't know, comments, or we cool? Todo nice, todo bien, todo correcto. Okay, good, good. Alrighty then. So that's pretty much the test. And one more time, don't forget to complete it before 12. Okay. So it's almost 9, so I'm going to take attendance before we continue, before we start with the following activity. So let me see. We're just going to follow same direction. Once you listen to your name, just say present and turn on your camera if possible. So we start. Ana Beatriz Campos de Guzmán.
Presentation.
Thank you very much, Beatriz. Next person, Blanca Elizabeth Alvarenga Mejía. Thank you very much, Blanquita. Then we have Carlos Antonio Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Thank you very much, Carlos. Good. Next we have Carlos Javier Crespin.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Carlos. Nice. Then we continue with Cristian Ernesto Lazo Flores. Cristian Ernesto. Oh, not here. Okay, he hasn't, well, he's not present right now. So we continue with Denise Grisel Brizuela.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you very much, Grisel. We continue with Ember Giovanni Polio.
Present.
Thank you very much, Ember. We continue with Francisca Elizabeth Martinez.
Present, teacher.
No vino Elizabeth.
No, yes, I am here.
There you go.
I am here.
Just to see you. Nice, very good, Elizabeth. Thank you. We continue with Jose Eduardo Guzmán. José Eduardo. Él sí no está. All right. So then we continue with Juan Carlos Rivas Jovel. Juan Carlos JC, not here. All right. So we continue with Karen Vanessa Moratalla. Not here either. So we continue with Luis Alfonso Martinez.
Present teacher.
Nice. Thank you very much, Luis. Then we continue with Maria Elena Guadalupe Peñate.
Present teacher.
All right. Excellent. Thank you, Maria Elena. We continue with Nelson Gabarrete Merino.
Present teacher.
All right. Thank you, Nelson. Very good. So we continue with Omar Francisco Hernandez.
Present.
Thank you very much, Omar. And we go with Oscar Arnulfo Villatoro.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Oscar. And last but not least, Jenny Zuleima Santos Chavez.
Present.
All right. Thank you very much, Jenny. Excellent. Okay. So that's pretty much it. So now that we took the attendance, we can go back and practice some of the things or some of the topics we were practicing in the book. And let's just go to, where am I? Let's just go to this page that is, let's see, page number, page number 27, right? Page 27. So on page 27, we have this little reading, right? We have an article in which we are talking about giving instructions to staff. Now, besides reading this article, we're going to answer some questions based on it. And what we're going to do first, I'm gonna read it for you. I'm gonna read it completely. And then some of you are going to help me to reread this article. So here we go. First, just listen and then I'll tell you how we're going to work with this activity. So it says, number one, don't assume they know what you mean. You know what they say, that assumption is the mother of all mistakes. Don't be the fool that assumes people know what you mean. With most people in your office or business, will be intuitive and switched on. They're not mind readers. An imperative when delivering clear instructions is to not assume the recipient knows what you mean. And this can be for anything from industry acronyms to who to contact in different departments or organizations. It will only take you a few seconds more to explain the details. Number two, be clear and specific. Everyone loves a waffle, dripping in maple syrup, please. But no one likes waffles in conversations, and especially not in an email or when it is a set of instructions. Whilst you don't want to ramble on in your set of instructions, that would be a waste of your time. And to be honest, they switched off after a while. You do want to ensure that your instructions are clear, specific, and concise. Personally, I prefer not to butter it up and would rather get straight to be the point on what needs to be actioned or delivered, rather than making the instructions too flowery, which will only confuse. Number three, give time frames. Do not confuse matters by not being specific with your time frames and deadlines. What you consider as soon might be very different from your colleagues. If you think soon is the next couple of hours, yet your staff who you have instructed consider it to be in a few days, then this communication is going to have serious implications in any business or project. Number four, give examples. whenever possible, make sure you give examples. This will be especially beneficial if they are new to the role or if they haven't carried out the task before. This will help to add clarity to your instructions and help form a clearer picture of what it is you mean and want. And there you go. Now, right below, we have some statements that we need to tell if these statements are true or false. Now, we're going to work this in small groups. What are we going to do besides telling if this is true or false? You're going to check the reading or the article, and I want you to also look for at least 5 words that you don't know, 5 words that are new for you, and that you try to find out the meaning of those words. So we are going to read the article. You are going to complete if the statements below are true or false, and you're going to get from the reading at least 5 words. Van a sacar 5 palabras nuevas de esta lectura que acabamos de tener. So you can read it again, and you can underline, or you can get these words. You can write them down on your notebook, right? So let's see. We're going to work in groups. So let's see. How many people are we? Okay. So let's see. Oops, wait. All right. So in the first group, I have Grisel, Nelson, and Jenny. All right. So you're going to work together. Group number 2, Ana Beatriz, Ember, and Omar. So you are group number 2. Group number 3, Carlos Antonio, Carlos Javier, and Francis Elizabeth, you're working together. And then we have, All right, then we have Luis Alfonso Martinez and María Elena Guadalupe. So you're working together. And the last one, it's a pair as well. So it's Blanquita and Oscar. All right. So there you go. So let's see. You will have just like, let's say, 7 to 8 minutes to complete the true or false section and to get at least 5 new words from this conversation. So I open the small rooms right now so that you can connect, and then we come back to the main session, all right? So you can start working now with your groups. Right, very good. Nice. Alrighty, so I guess we are all here now. No se me quedó nadie perdido. Let's see. No, right. So here you are. Okay. Okay, then. So let's see. Let's check the answers for this practice. Let's see how you did. Let's see if you got the right ideas here. So let's see. In the first, well, the first thing you had to do, true or false, right? So let me see. Can you help me with number one, Jenny? Can you read it and tell me if it's... Hello, Jenny.
For is false.
Ah, it's false. Can you read it?
False.
Uh-huh. According? Uh-huh.
According to the article, it is fine. Mm-hmm. It is fine to make assumptions.
Assumptions.
Assumptions is false.
False. Very good. What does the article say about it? What do I need to do, Jenny?
The article don't assume they know what you mean.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Number one.
Nice. Very good. So don't make an assumption like that, right? Don't think they understood, right? Mm-mm. Try to double check, right, if they or if people actually got the right idea. Excellent, Jenny. Very good. So, Jenny, you select another person. Alguien que se vea que se está durmiendo, Jenny.
Se está durmiendo. Ya todos se activaron cuando dijo eso.
Ay, todos ahí durmiéndose.
Sí. Bueno, al azar, quizás.
All right.
Vaya, ahí el compañero que estuvo conmigo, Nelson.
Oh, okay, there you go. Nelson, Mr. Nelson.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Jenny. Number two.
Number two. Let's see. Read it, Nelson.
Number two. It is important to go study point to be clear.
Straight to the point.
True. Verdadero.
Straight to the point. True. Very good. Exactly.
Oh,
why? Okay. Uh-huh. Why is it important, Nelson? To go straight to the point. Why do you think it's important? It's important because,
It's important to go straight in the point to be clear.
Straight to the point to be clear. But why, Nelson? In your own words, en sus propias palabras, Nelson. Why is it important?
Ah, okay. It's important. Bueno, es que no puedo decir en inglés.
try. Si bien iba. It's important because. Porque.
It's important because in the bueno para claro con las personas no sé in the...
to be clear in directions or with people.
Okay.
All right. Okay, Nelson. Nice. So Nelson, you select another person.
Teacher, sorry.
Okay.
Okay, wait. Yes, Luis, you had a question?
Sorry, teacher, in this case, please be clear and specific. It is saying, decir las cosas cara a cara.
To say things face to face?
To say face to face.
Could be, right? It could be.
Could be.
Okay. Yeah, and also there is a little, he's using an expression here. No one likes waffle in conversations. Waffle is, no es solo el postre, right? It's not a dessert. It's not just like a pancake. Those are waffles. But we also have this word that it says no one likes waffle in conversation. Waffle is just what we would say in Spanish, parlotear, right? So to start to talk about, a lot about something without reaching a point.
Many words.
Exactly. It's like to go wordy, right? The same happens. He says over here, he mentions, I prefer not to body it up. This is similar to what we were saying. I prefer not to body it up. To body it up is to talk like in a really pompous way, right? Like flattering. Without saying or without going straight to the point, right? So it's the same thing. So very good. So nice. All right. So Nelson, I'm sorry. Who did you select? Who was the person?
Ember.
Ember.
Mr. Ember.
Mr. Ember. Let's see, Ember. So can you read number three?
Okay, chair. People will get confused with the direction if we use too many words. Uh-huh. It's true.
It's true, right? So if I'm saying this like with a lot of words, not giving you like not going straight to the point, maybe you're not going to get the idea in the end, right? So I guess this one is really clear. So thank you, Ember. So Ember, you choose another person.
Teacher.
Yes, Elizabeth.
I have a question to ask. Uh-huh. In English, how do you say al grano?
Straight to the point. Straight to the point. So we write it. Let me write it here so that everybody can see it. Straight to the point. So we can say, for example, go straight to the point. Go
straight to the point.
Go straight to the point. Es como vaya al grano. So when someone is telling us about a problem, y mire que fíjese que me bajé del bus, y ahí cuando me bajé del bus, como así, just go straight to the point. What happened to you, right? What was the problem that you had? So that is the use of this expression, right? Nice. So let's see, Ember, you select another person.
Carlos Crespin.
All right, Mr. Carlos Crespin. Number four, Carlos.
Okay, okay.
Let's
number
see.
Four, to avoid misunderstandings.
Misunderstandings? Uh-huh.
I'm sorry, teacher, pero trabé lengua esa palabra.
Es algo larga. Misunderstandings, right? Misunderstandings.
One should be very clear in time frames.
One should be very clear in time frames. Repeat it.
Okay, watch. Very clear in time frames.
Clear in time frames. Uh-huh.
For me, it's true, teacher.
True.
All right. Yes.
Nice. Very good. So what happens, Carlos, if I say, for example, you give me the report as soon as possible. So what happens if I say that? Or what could happen? If your boss tells you, give me the report as soon as you can. What do you understand?
Is, bueno, in Spanish, teacher.
No, in Spanish, no. In English. What do you do? If your boss tells you, hey, Carlos, please give me the report as soon as you can, please. Tan pronto como pueda, as soon as you can, Carlos. What do you understand then? When are you going to give him the report?
Quiero ver. Para, ¿cómo dice? Para evitar malentendidos.
To avoid misunderstandings here.
Hay que dejar bien claro el tiempo. Ajá. De todo.
¿Pero qué haría usted? Así. Si a usted su jefe le dice, no, y me das el reporte tan pronto como podás. ¿Para cuándo entiende qué es eso?
Ayer.
Right now. Yesterday, right now.
Right now.
It could be, right? So, ¿qué pasa si yo tal vez lo entendí diferente? I maybe had thought, as soon as I can. Ahorita no puedo, right? I can't right now. So, I'm going to do it tomorrow, right? But then my boss tells me in the afternoon, Rolando, and what about the report? But you said that as soon as I can, right now, I'm busy doing something else. So we got to be clear. So we got to give deadlines or due dates very clear. Like, this is for tomorrow. I need this for today at 3 p.m., right? By around 3, I need it ready, etc., etc. So provide specific time frames. No hay cuando pueda, or as soon as possible, etc., etc. Try to be clear, right? So good. So Carlos, select another person, the last one.
Okay, teacher. Quiero ver. Ana Beatriz.
Ana Beatriz, let's see. Beatriz, can you help me with number 5?
It is fine if the employee make a mistake late. Later, we can show examples. Is true, teacher?
True. Is it true? When do we show the examples? After the mistake or before the mistake? What's better?
Mistake, teacher, is
after.
Me olvidó qué significaba, teacher.
Before. I'm sorry, Beatriz.
Mistake.
Error. Error.
Los errores.
Cometer un error. Make a mistake.
No sé cómo pronunciarlo en inglés, pero o sea, siempre van a cometer errores.
Ajá.
Y es retroalimentar sobre esos errores para no volver a cometer. Así lo entendí.
Provide feedback. Literally, it says, it is fine if the employees make a mistake. Later, we can show examples. Está bien que los empleados cometan un error. Después les podemos mostrar ejemplos, ¿no?
Exacto.
Pero estará bien. O sea, y si ese error me costó a mí, híjole, miles de dólares en alguna pérdida.
Y ¿cómo decirlo? Y es no muy... se me olvidaba, no muy extenso, o sea, no muy fuerte, no sé cómo decirlo, teacher.
Not that serious, maybe?
Yes, it's como...
Not so bad? Not so bad?
Not yeah, it's, it's small.
It's a small it's mistake? Small. Si me lo, yes. Voy a tener que sacar del sueldo de este empleado. No, mentira.
No.
Okay. No, here, this one, I would say it's false, right? ¿Y por qué sería falso? Porque puedo mostrar el error antes de que se... Bueno, perdón. Puedo mostrar el ejemplo antes de que cometan el error. So, para evitar...
Siempre lo cometen.
Ay, caray, ahí sí ya me lavo las manos como manager. ¿Qué le digo? Yo te enseñé.
Bueno,
yo
eso
te
sí. Lo
dije, ¿no? Ya no queda que el manager no me dijo, right? Carlos, Javier, you raised your hand.
Yes, teacher. For example, in the company where
a work. Mm-hmm. We are here to do it hiking from the first time. Uh-huh. And that is why we are training.
Ah, exactly. So there you go. What we do, for example, we train people. We design an onboarding plan with a new member of the staff, right? We try to teach this person to show examples so that they don't make mistakes when they are in his or her position, right? So very good. There you go. All right. Now, what about words that were new in this reading? What are some of the words that you took out from the reading? Volunteer.
Me, teacher.
Aha, Maria Elena.
Assume, assumption, mistake, acronyms, number.
Okay, very good. So a couple of words there. So the first one you say assume, right?
Yes.
And did you look for the meaning or no? You just get the word.
That's the word.
Just the word. Okay. Assume is to think that something is in one way, but you cannot be sure about it, right? In theory, it's like in Spanish when we say asumir, right? To assume. So to think that they understood, but how do you know, right? Then you are assuming. So there you go. What else?
Assumption is como parecido. Eh?
Which one?
Assumption.
Assumption, exactly. It's the noun. Ya no es el verbo, sino el sustantivo. Una, it's like, how do we say that in Spanish? Una asunción? No. Oh my, I don't know. But it's like the name we give to the action of assuming. It's an assumption, right? There you go. So yeah, it's related.
Cuando uno dice, yo asumí.
Ajá, right. Yo asumí que hoy no iba a venir a trabajar, ¿verdad? Y no, era al revés, que iba a salir tarde.
Dicen que ya dijeron que era error, como un error que no cometo.
Exactly, yeah.
Acronyms.
This is, for example, when we have, let me see, I'm going to give you one that it's from Santa Ana, INSA, right? This is an acronym, Instituto Nacional de Santa Ana.
El Instituto INSA.
There you go, huh? So there you go, you know. So this is an acronym. The letter.
Yo conozco.
Excellent, yeah. So, so there you go, an example of an acronym. Another example, it can be, what else? USA is an acronym, the United States of America. So acronyms is what we know as siglas, right, in Spanish. So it's every time we make a word with letters, right? But those letters, they mean something. So those are acronyms.
Okay.
Nice. All right, very good, nice, very good, nice. So, any other words?
Me, teacher.
Here, let's see, Ember.
With.
Whilst. All right, that's a good one. Like this one. La primera vez que vimos esta palabra está mal escrita acá. Esta es, ¿verdad?
Yes.
There you go. So here they made a mistake. So this is not correct. The correct word is this one, whilst. And this is just a synonym for the word. Wait. This is a synonym for the word. Here we got it. While, right? So it's the same, right? Es un sinónimo. It means mientras, whilst you don't want to ramble on in your set of instructions, da 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 da.
Mientras.
Mientras. Uh-huh. So there you go. Mientras. Any other words? Are we cool?
Title, teacher.
Which one?
Title.
Let's see, syrup. This one here. Ah, nice. Yeah, syrup. In this case, we have maple syrup. This is like syrup. Just the word syrup is a liquid. It's jarabe, right? Maple syrup. Nosotros le decimos miel de maple, pero literalmente lo traduciríamos como jarabe de maple, which is like a leaf. Right. We also use the word syrup with medicine. So you take a syrup. Tome un jarabe para la tos, right? Cough syrup. So it's also possible, right? Nice. Any other words?
Right there.
Let's see. Where is it? In what paragraph?
Let's say
second paragraph.
Second paragraph. Let's see.
This line down.
Where?
Down.
Down. This one. Flowery?
Rather.
Rather. Dos líneas arriba.
Ah, rather. Right. This one. Rather. Rather, so, and would rather get straight to be the point. Would rather, this one is like an expression we use, like in this case, it's like to express, como cuando nosotros decimos, mejor esto, no, mejor hago esto, and would rather, y mejor voy, diríamos acá, al grano. Voy, or would rather get straight to the point. Y acá, para entender quizás bien la idea, lo leemos desde aquí, ¿no? Personally, I prefer not to butter it up. And would rather, personalmente preferiría no, digamos, adornarlo. Y más bien, y preferiría, o sea, lo podemos traducir de varias maneras, ir directo al grano, ir directo al punto, right? So, la usamos como para dar la idea de que no hacemos esto, o no queremos hacer esto, sino que otra cosa, right? De ahí el would rather. So, that's pretty much. Any other word besides that?
Flowery, creo que
la mencionó también. Flowery. Yeah. Flowery, it says, rather than making the instructions too flowery, de ponerle mucho adorno a algo, ¿no? De eso, de ahí viene que el término flower, in this case, taken as an adjective, flowery. Y no dar instrucciones muy adornadas, muy extensas, podríamos decirlo. Which will only confuse, right? That would be confusing. So there you go. Any other word? Okay. So I guess that was pretty much it. Then the rest of the words, they were, I would say, not that difficult, right? Common. All right. So I guess this is the last thing that we're going to do. And here we have the last practice. And this is also something that comes in the test. So we're going to work in this one here. If you remember, this one is about the use of there is and there are. Acá tenemos unas preguntas in which we need to use is there or are there, depending on the subject that we have for each question. That is from 1 to 7. And in the last one, it says, unscramble the words to create sentences. Here, you're just going to unscramble, van a ponerla en orden. And this is related to the expression to be allowed to or not to be allowed to, affirmative or negative. So I'm going to give you like, let's say 5-6 minutes for you to complete it. We're going to work individually this time. So we are not going to go to the breakout rooms. You can just work on it right now. And I'll give you just like 6 minutes for you to finish. Then we check the correct answers, all right? So 6 minutes to complete the exercise, and then we check the answers together. So let's see. If you need some help, just let me know. Exercise 1 and 2. All right, did you finish? Not yet.
Not yet, teacher.
Okay, no worries. Okay, okay. Okay, let's see. Let me give you a hand with the first part. In the first part, you were just supposed to write the question, well, what was missing in the question. So because of the time, I'm just going to give you the answers here. So number one, is there any paper in the printer? Number two, are there any computers available? Number three, is there enough personnel at your company? Number four, are there many conference rooms in your workplace? Number five, is there much light in your workplace? Number six, are there many things to do every day? And number seven, are there good places to have a break? There you go.
Can you repeat the number five, teacher, please?
Number five. Number five, is there much light in your workplace? Uh-huh.
Okay.
Nice, excellent. And then we had the sentences here that you were supposed to write in the correct order. So it says, you're not allowed to wear informal clothes. You are not allowed to wear informal clothes. That's number one. Number two, employees are not allowed to smoke. Number three, it is not allowed to bring in children, right? It is not allowed to bring in children. Number four, it says, we are not allowed to extend our lunch time. We are not allowed to extend our lunch time. And the last one, number five, It says, people are not allowed to check in late. People are not allowed to check in late. And that was it. Okay, guys, with this, you should be ready for the test. I don't think it's going to give you like too many problems. Just be careful how you complete and how you provide the answers, especially in the sections that we mentioned during the class. So I'm going to take the last attendance for the night. Y hoy le tocaría quedarse, let me see, y Nelson Gabarrete, ¿tiene chancecito de quedarse, Nelson?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect, nice, Nelson. Okay, then, so then we proceed to take attendance. So, number one, Ana Beatriz Campos de Guzmán.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Beatriz. Y Blanca Elizabeth Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
Thanks, Blanquita. Y Carlos Antonio Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Thank you, Carlos. Very good. Number four, Carlos Javier Crespin López.
Present, teacher.
Thanks a lot, Carlos. Then we have Cristian Ernesto Lazo. Cristian, not here. Okay. So then we have Denise Grisel Brizuela.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Grisel. Then we go with number seven, Ember Giovanni Polillo.
Present, teacher.
Thanks, Ember. We continue with Francisca Elizabeth Martinez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Ellie. We continue with Jose Eduardo Guzmán Álvarez.
Present, teacher.
All right, there you go. Nice, Jose Eduardo. Then we continue with Juan Carlos Rivas Jubel. JC, not here. So we continue with Karen Vanessa Moratalla. Not here. So we continue with Luis Alfonso Martinez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Luis. We continue with Maria Elena Guadalupe Peñate.
Present.
Thanks a lot, Maria Elena. And we continue with Nelson Gabarrete Merino.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Nelson. Next, Omar Francisco Hernandez.
Present.
Thank you, Omar. Oscar Arnulfo Villatoro.
Present.
Thanks, Oscar. And Jenny Suleima Santos.
Present.
Thank you very much, Jenny. Okay, guys. So we're going to stop right here then. Y no se les olvide, ahora también, último día para ponerse el día con las tareas. El examen, right? No lo olviden, antes de las 12, ya ténganlo listo. Y that's it, right? Acuérdense cómo completar la tercera parte del test. No se lo va a olvidar. Y that's it, right? Thank you very much for joining today's class. I'll see you tomorrow and have a nice evening, guys. Take care and have a good night.
Good night.
All right. Good night. Sweet dreams, people.
Bye. Good
night.
Good night. Bye. Okay, Nelson. Vaya, Nelson. Tenemos 10 minutitos para aprovechar.
Okay, teacher.
Cualquier duda que
sea. Al máximo.
Al máximo, aproveche. Ahorita es cuando pueden preguntarme cualquier cosa, ¿no? Puede ser, si no es del tema que hemos estado viendo, pueden ser temas que hayan quedado por ahí, algún vacío, ¿verdad? De algún tema anterior, de otros niveles, igual los podemos
hablar. Ah, ok.
Nice.
Lo único que no me queda muy claro es, por lo menos, vaya, entiendo que usando el, bueno, lo que estamos viendo ahorita, que hemos visto el último, el there are y el there is. Uh-huh. El there are, tengo entendido que es para plural, ¿verdad?
Correcto.
y el there is para singular, pero no me queda claro cuando veo que hay oraciones, vaya, por lo menos que comience con there are o there is, y hay unas que comienzan con is. Eso es cuando es para pregunta o como no, eso sí no lo comprendo mucho.
Vale, así justamente lo que usted me acaba de decir, así es. A veces vamos a tener un ejemplo así, por ejemplo, there is some water in the glass. There is some water in the glass. Uh-huh. Acá yo lo que tengo es una oración afirmativa, entonces... Y prácticamente
ah, okay.
La estructura normal, ¿verdad? Que es el there is en este caso.
Sí, lo, there is some glass.
Lo mismo me pasa con el there are. There are five people outside. There are five people outside. Hay cinco personas afuera. There are five people outside.
Afuera, ajá.
Ajá. So... Aquí solo estoy ocupando las expresiones de manera afirmativa. Pero, ¿qué pasa si yo quiero hacer una pregunta? Como en todo la estructura de las preguntas, yo necesito comenzar con el auxiliar, que en este caso es el verb to be. Entonces, yo diría, para la primera, is there some water in the glass? Right, is there some?
Hay algunas.
Hay algo, right? Hay algo de agua en el vaso. Is there
hay
some
algo.
Water?
Uh-huh. De agua en el vaso.
Exacto. Is there hay some algo. Water in the glass? There you go. O también la segunda que quedaría. Are there five people outside? Are there five people outside? Hay cinco personas afuera, right? So, entonces, como decíamos, va a depender.
O sea, ¿qué es lo que?
Ajá.
Vaya, por lo menos en la segunda que dice, ¿verdad? En la que está normalmente dice hay cinco personas afuera, así hay.
Uh-huh. Ajá.
¿Verdad?
Ajá.
Y hay pregunta. Ya la hago solo porque, o sea, solo cambio el auxiliar de el to be en este caso, ¿verdad?
Ajá, solo vamos
solo
a cambiar
pongo,
la
ajá,
posición.
Ah, are there five people inside? O sea, y el signo de interrogación es el que hace ya la pregunta y el y el cambio del to be, ¿verdad?
Exacto.
Porque si lo leo lo mismo, o sea, si lo leo normalmente como afirmativa, como en pregunta, gramáticamente lo mismo suena.
Prácticamente.
Que lleva así una interrogación, si lo leo ya en español.
Nosotros en español lo que hacemos, Nelson, es que le damos como una entonación diferente. Por ejemplo, a mí me dicen, ¿puedo ir al baño? Si yo digo, yo puedo ir al baño. Yo puedo, ¿verdad? Se lo estoy afirmando. Pero si yo lo quiero preguntar, es la misma estructura, pero diferente entonación. ¿Puedo ir al baño? ¿Me da permiso? ¿Puedo ir al baño?
Ah, ok.
Entonces, en inglés no. En inglés no puedo solo cambiar, digamos, la entonación de una oración afirmativa y pasar la pregunta, solo poniéndole el signo y cambiándole la entonación que le hago a la oración, sino que... En inglés, sí necesito hacer un pequeño cambio, ¿verdad? Que en este caso es usar el verb to be al inicio para que se entienda que estoy haciendo una pregunta. Y mientras que si en una oración afirmativa, empiezo con there, right? There is or there are. Y sin mayor problema.
Okay.
Ajá. There you go. Excelente.
Okay. Estamos ir aprendiendo que realmente yo no inglés, o sea, me gusta porque sí me gusta, por eso me he metido en esto.
Ajá.
No, realmente yo inglés no mucho he recibido.
No
he recibido mucho inglés.
No, pero bueno.
Recibía una hora y ¿sabe dónde? Yo estudié en Santa Ana, por eso conozco ahí Santa Ana.
Ah, mire qué interesante. ¿A dónde? ¿A dónde estudiaba?
No sé si comentar allá por Fíjese que allá por el círculo, donde está el círculo por dentro, como que voy para la colonia y no recuerdo. La cosa es que es una cosa de los salesianos, una ciudad de los niños.
La ciudad de los niños.
Rafael Campos, sí. Llama la escuela.
Ajá, sí, yo me acuerdo.
Yo ahí estudié, ahí saqué mi noveno. Con el padre Rossi. Conozco ahí el Colón, conozco el Cerro Tecana, bueno, fui ahí al INSA, al estadio, ahí por Mario Calvo, todo eso me lo iba a cantar, Río Zarco.
Yo igual ahí anduve al patín y todo.
Entonces, sí, mi inglés ha sido bien. A mí me gustaba irme a bañar allá a Panteo.
Sí.
A la piscina pública.
Yo ahí aprendí a nadar en Panteo. Sí.
Era.
Sí, ahí aprendí. Mi papá me
llevó. Los domingos lo íbamos para allá nosotros.
Igual, mi papá nos llevaba
a okay.
Los domingos.
Habían unos lavaderos públicos abajo después de la piscina.
Correcto, ajá. Cabal.
Pues eso sí. Sí, no, realmente yo estudié ya hace bastante y el inglés solo lo recibí en octavo y noveno.
Uh-huh.
Y fue bien poco, lo daban una hora cada.
Sí, era
sí,
bien.
Fue bien poco, pero sí, mínimo. Me gusta mucho.
Ajá, no, qué bueno. Bien
mínimo, igual que la computación para mí. Pero bien. Que me cuesta, teacher, es también el tema de ayer, por lo menos para las direcciones. Lo vimos en el módulo en el módulo 3 lo que lo vi.
Ajá.
Pero solo, digamos, sí, ahí hay lo que hay que practicar, son las preposiciones, ¿verdad?
Exacto. Y aprenderse
de las direcciones.
Aprenderse de memoria las preposiciones, qué significan, para, o sea, tener el vocabulario fresco y listo a la hora de dar una dirección. Y ahí uno lo va ocupando
porque
como uno lo necesita.
Y ayer sí me sentí un poco, ayer creo que fue que tocó ese, sí, ayer fue, ¿verdad?
Fue
sí, me sentí un poco perdido.
Antes de ayer, ajá, sí, el día antes de ayer fue.
O antier, antier fue, perdón, sí, antier sí. Fue, es cierto. Me sentí correcto. Un poco perdido porque, o sea, lo puso el teacher Bernaldo, lo había puesto, pero a dar dirección, digamos, de donde yo trabajo, de mi lugar de trabajo, enfrente de qué queda, o a la par, o en la esquina, eso sí los enseñó él.
Ajá.
El día antier creo que con usted fue muy diferente, como que había que buscar un punto de partida, algo así, ¿le entendí?
Ajá, sí, era más práctico de hacerlo más general,
¿verdad?
Para ocuparlo para ubicarlo desde cualquier punto de referencia.
Ajá, entonces me sentí un poco confuso, fue donde dice la rotonda.
Ajá, roundabout.
Ahí sentí un poco.
Ajá. Sí, ahí es
no recuerdo haberla visto de ahí.
Sí, me imagino. Ahí es de aprenderse de memoria prácticamente, las prepositions y todo eso. Sí. Pero poco a poco, Nelson, vamos a ir ahí hallándole usted, bueno...
La verdad que sí, porque a mí me cuesta, por esa vez hay momentos que no hay ni que hablar. No es como mi compañero, que yo siento que ellos sí hablan más que, o sea, se entienden más. No, a mí me cuesta. Realmente ha sido bien poco mi inglés, man.
Sí, no, pero tranquilo, ¿verdad? Usted vaya a su ritmo, y igual, si en algún momento quiere que la vuelva a explicar, usted me dice, teacher, mire, explíqueme esto otra vez, y yo con gusto, Nelson. Así que, ahí estamos.
Ok, gracias, teacher. Sí.
Excelente, Nelson. Thank you very much.
Yo creo que ese era lo más.
Okay, very good. Excelente.
Ese era lo más que te quería preguntar. Ok.
Chivísimo, Nelson. Un gusto, entonces, haberle ayudado con esto. Y pues, cualquier otra consulta, ahí estamos. Quedamos a la orden.
Ok, thank you,
Nelson. My pleasure. Have a good night, Nelson. Bye-bye.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Bye.